Welcome back to Get Down to Business, the show all about small business jobs and entrepreneurship. I am super excited for our next conversation, and we're going to talk a little bit about good enough. In today's world, change is the only constant, and the bar for success is only rising higher. So gone are the days when being good enough could satisfy customers and beat back the competition. So what's the solution? Leaders and businesses must evolve from being good to great to superior. And that's exactly what I want to talk to my next guest, Rusty Komori, who is an inspirational keynote speaker, executive coach, and tennis professional based in Honolulu, Hawaii. He was the head tennis coach at a school where his boys' varsity teams won an unprecedented 22 consecutive state championship, a national record in all sports that stands to this day. He has received many accolades, and he has written a book. It's called Superior, Creating a Superior Culture of Excellence. Rusty Komori, welcome to the program. Thanks so much for joining us.
Oh, I'm super excited to be with you today.
Absolutely. So as mentioned in the intro, you are the coach behind 22 consecutive state sports championships. That's an all-time record in sports. Tell us a little bit about your story.
Yeah, I was the head coach for the Punahou School boys varsity tennis team for 22 years, and we were fortunate to win 22 consecutive state championships. And the media had said that that's the longest, most perfect state championship streak in the United States in all sports. And after retiring as head coach in 2015, that's when I decided to write books. And I'm just thinking, is there a way that I could help maybe all students or all schools or all businesses or sports teams or families? Because parents are leaders, and I just wanted to try to do something bigger and greater. And now I'm doing executive coaching and keynote speaking and talking to you right here.
Absolutely. Well, Rusty, I'm glad you are. And you say constantly that evolving from being good enough to superior is a must-have in today's world. Can you give us a few examples?
Yes. Yeah, so I always say there's a gigantic difference between a culture of excellence versus a superior culture of excellence. And there's a tremendous difference between attention to details versus superior discipline details. And we've all heard the term high achievers before. Well, in superior, I invented the term superior achievers because there's a difference. I like to train people to become high achievers. But once they do, I want to coach them to become superior achievers. And I meet with a lot of CEOs every week, and a CEO might tell me, hey, Coach Rusty, I read, you know, all three of your books. I'm like, okay, great. I'm thinking that's a high achiever. Another CEO will tell me, hey, Coach Rusty, I read all three of your books three times each. Now that's a superior achiever. So there is a difference, and that's just a simple example there.
Yeah, absolutely. So our listeners are all looking to gain that edge. Many of them are entrepreneurs, small business owners. What steps should they take first to gain that edge to, again, for that focus on constant self-improvement?
Yeah, you know, I always say, I get asked a lot that, you know, how do you achieve greatness? And I know that greatness is a choice and excellence is a choice. Courage, kindness are choices. Positivity, perseverance, resiliency are choices. Self-discipline is a choice. Self-discipline leads to habits, which lead to success. So I want to really help people understand that you have the power of choice. You can choose to be complacent, or you can choose to be proactive and try to do things that will really influence the goals that you want to achieve.
Absolutely. We know that people in general tend to focus on results, but you, Rusty, you say that that is a mistake. How so?
Yeah, I like to focus on performance goals, and we all want to win. We all want to make money, or we all want to hit certain sales numbers. But how do you do it? What do you need to do to win? What do you need to do to make money? Well, it's performance goals. You need to figure out what are these little things that will vault you in the right direction every single day. And I like to focus on behaviors and rewarding behaviors such as attitude and effort, because as a coach, that's all we can really require from our team members, is to really give not a great effort. I want a superior effort, and not a great attitude. I want a superior attitude. So really focusing on performance goals influence results.
Absolutely. I'm chatting with the author of a new book. It's called Superior, Creating a Superior Culture of Excellence. And that's Rusty Komori, who's an international keynote speaker, executive coach, and tennis professional. And Rusty, in your book, Superior, you talk about the power of the 1% principle. What does this involve?
Yeah. So how can you be 1% better today than you were yesterday? Can you add 1% more knowledge today? Can you learn something new? Can you improve 1% on a weakness? Can you improve 1% on a strength? So it's not about doing great things. It's about doing the little things that lead to accomplishing the great things. So that's the 1% principle. Everyone can do that, because it's as simple as running one lap on a track. The next time you go out there, you might run one lap and a quarter. And then the next time, one lap and a half. And before you know it, you'll be running 1 mile. And before you know it, after that, running a marathon might become a possibility. But how did it all start? It all started with the 1% principle.
True. And it's one thing to win and make it to the top. But your reputation of, again, the 22 consecutive titles over there, staying up there at the top, can be a whole other issue. You've excelled at this. What insights can you share from your own life experiences?
Yeah, I'm a big believer in not practicing something until you get it right, but practice something until you can't get it wrong. So we all want to work on certain things, but you don't work on something until you barely get it. You work on something until you own it, until it becomes a part of you, until it becomes something that you do, and then it becomes your identity. So really having that focus on practicing something until you own it, that's one of the keys that I did with my teams that allowed us to not just achieve success, but to sustain success.
That's powerful stuff, Rusty. And you transitioned from sports coach to executive coach nearly a decade ago. So what are you focused on now?
Well, I love helping executives to really help maximize their potential for themselves and then their business, their team's potential. And one thing that I focus on is to really control three things: control your thoughts, control your mouth, and control your hands. If we can control what we think, what we say, and what we do, we have a great chance of controlling our destiny and achieving the goals that we want. But we need to control those three things: our thoughts, our mouth, and our hands. And it's very simple, but it's very powerful.
Indeed, it is. Absolutely. And certainly there's testimony that your books are saving people's lives. How have they been able to help so many people?
Yeah. So since my first book came out to this date, 10 people have come to me sharing that they were contemplating suicide. And then after reading my books, it changed their mindset and it saved their life. And one of the 10 is Crime Stoppers coordinator, Sergeant Chris Kim, who is in Honolulu, Hawaii, and he's a public figure. And he read the first book, Beyond the Lines, and literally it changed his mindset and it saved his life. And when I ask these people, you know, what is it about the books that that really helped you? And they said, well, you talk about choices, you talk about making people matter, you talk about contributing to society, you talk about welcoming adversity, looking forward to challenges, you talk about looking at that one positive among 20 negatives. You talk about inspiring hope, and really that's what it's about. And I'm trying to change the narrative from mental health to mental fitness, because all of us need to improve our physical fitness and all of us need to improve our mental fitness as well.
Absolutely. I've been chatting with Rusty Komori, again, the author of Superior, Creating a Superior Culture of Excellence. Thank you for sharing your life experiences, your advice with our listeners. And I do want to make sure our listeners can get in touch with you and, of course, pick up a copy of the book. How can they do that?
Yeah, so the books are available on Amazon and Barnes & Noble and on my website, rustykomori.com.
Well, thank you so much, Rusty, for, again, inspiring our listeners. We'll link in our show notes. And as always, we encourage our listeners to get in touch with all of our sponsors, Tom Mirabali, for all of your Health Insurance and Affordable Care Act questions and needs. You can reach them 630-863-3477, 630-863-3477, or healthplanchicago.com. A quick break. We'll be right back.